Hey guys, before I begin this breakdown, I wanted to give a huge shout out to my sponsor, Manscaped.com. For all of your male grooming needs, they have an awesome 20% off special for their Perfect Bag 2.0. Go ahead and use the promo code SAM20 when you place your order. In the modern NFL, every team is in a quarterback cycle. You have teams like the Falcons and the Colts who have their quarterback and are just trying to compete inside of a defined window. Then you have teams like the Giants and the Jaguars who need a quarterback and aren't going to be competitive until they get one. In this NFL draft, only one team will be lucky enough to grab this year's top quarterback, Dwayne Haskins. Haskins, who didn't start until his final season at Ohio State, is the number one quarterback on my board. He combines size, arm strength, and all the intangibles you look for to lead a franchise. The one main thing that he's missing, though, experience. With just one season starting, he needs to prove that he can continue developing in the NFL as he's already shown a very high ceiling. To start this breakdown, Haskins almost exclusively lined up in shotgun in the Buckeyes' offense. They ran a lot of zone read option, they ran the occasional run-pass option, and they used a lot of West Coast concepts to spread out the defense. They loved running drag-and-drive concepts, but they also ran a fair number of smash, triangle mesh, and spacing concepts to quickly get the ball to the receivers. To operate this offense, the quarterback has to be accurate and he has to be good at identifying defenses pre-snap to make quick post-snap decisions. Haskins excelled in this system. He was great at IDing man versus zone coverage before the snap, and he used that knowledge to attack the defense where they're weak. My favorite thing about Haskins as I went through his tape was that he was making full field reads starting at game one this season. He would take the ball, drop back finding the safeties, and then he would progress through his reads to get to his target. He would then throw a catchable pass, and this would allow his offense to move the chains. For as much as we think college offenses baby their quarterbacks by giving them only half-field reads or by running only screens, this was not the case for Haskins. His football IQ is very impressive. While I can show you a number of examples, let's start with this one against Nebraska. The defense is in a nickel package while facing Ohio State's trips bunch to the right. Haskins is in shotgun, and the receivers run a triangle mesh concept over the center of the field. The right drag route held the left curl flat defender outside, while the left drag route held the buzz defender in place in his hook curl zone. This gave the spot route a one-on-one with the inside linebacker. Haskins recognized the coverage quickly, and he threw a quick and catchable pass to his target to pick up the first down. While this may seem simple, yes, he found an open guy, but it's his quickness and his understanding of zone defenses that allowed him to complete these passes routinely. He'd be a killer fit in a West Coast offense. If the Redskins can somehow get their hands on him, I guarantee you that Jay Gruden would absolutely love him. Now, not only did Haskins do this against zone coverage, but he beat man using his accuracy and his understanding of leverage as well. Here's an example from the Purdue game. After motioning a receiver across the formation, the defense adjusted by sending their safety into man coverage on the slot receiver. They then put the other safety back into a deep zone. Purdue is in cover one man on this play while running off man coverage on the trip side of the formation. After the snap, Haskins was immediately under pressure. He stepped up, shifted to his right, and then he placed the ball in stride to his receiver as he was about to get hit. This took courage, this took poise, and Haskins did this while he knew he was going to get wrecked inside the pocket. Just a great play showing these traits. Now, if you follow college football, you'll know that Purdue was Ohio State's one and only loss this season. They were destroyed and manhandled in every aspect of this game. After reading comments from people all over the internet, it seems like a lot of people blame Haskins for this loss. They claimed his spotty placement and inconsistent reads were why the Buckeyes lost this game. While there is truth to this, it wasn't entirely his fault. He had a bad game, but there were so many mistakes by other members of his team. He tried multiple times to lead his receivers open, but his receivers simply dropped it. Nobody, including his offensive line, was on the same page in this game. Jumping to the end of this game, he threw an ugly, ugly pick six. This was his fault. It's clear he was trying to get the ball out as soon as the receiver crossed the linebacker, but he either expected him to sit or he just missed through it. Regardless, I put the blame on this play on Haskins. However, you can't look at this throw and a few other missed opportunities and completely blame him while ignoring all the penalties, poor blitz pickups, and miscommunications that I saw in this game. Moving on, one thought that kept going through my head as I was going through his tape is how difficult it is for college quarterbacks to throw with anticipation. Now, I don't mean Haskins has a hard time doing it, but rather in general, I mean it's surprisingly difficult for college QBs and wide receivers to connect on these throws. They have to be worked on, and there has to be clear chemistry, and I just don't think they have enough practice time to perfect them. This is a thought I had last season as I went through Josh Rosen and Sam Darnold, and it seemed like anytime either those two quarterbacks or Dwayne Haskins attempted to throw a receiver open, the receivers were never on the same page. Haskins literally ass-tapped a receiver down the field. It was crazy. It was a perfectly thrown ball that his receiver had no idea was coming. Seeing this multiple times per game was excruciating. It happened in the Purdue game, but it literally happened in every single game I watched. Versus Maryland, Haskins led his receiver on what should have been a touchdown. His receiver simply lost it. The Buckeyes ran a sail concept up the right sideline. This is a three-level read attacking Maryland's cover three zone dog defense. Even though Maryland rushed five on this play, Haskins had plenty of space to throw his pass. He found the safety who was over by the left hash mark. He then found the deep right cornerback who was stretched out too far to the right sideline, and he had an opening in the back of the end zone for this throw. He launched the pass smack dab in the middle of these two defenders, but his receiver failed to track it over his shoulder. This should have been a touchdown, but the pass fell incomplete. After watching this last play, I think this is where being on an NFL team will instantly help Haskins. If he can establish a relationship with a deep receiver, think of a guy like Odell Beckham Jr., they're going to make these catches in the pros. While I thought Haskins showed enough aggressiveness to attack defenses between zones, I think he can get better at throwing with anticipation on underneath and center of the field routes. He's late too frequently on post routes and hitch patterns, where I want him to get rid of the ball more quickly. Maryland is playing Tampa 2 on this play. There's a natural hole between the dropping Mike linebacker and the deep left safety. The Buckeyes have a post route, which is a perfect route to attack this coverage. However, Haskins waited too long to throw it. He had the hole, but the linebacker was able to get his hands on the pass, and Haskins was lucky that this ball was intercepted. While Haskins is generally pretty accurate on short and medium passes, he needs to work on his touch accuracy. He's incredible in bullet passes, but touch and lob throws to lead a receiver are just something he needs to get better at. This pass against Purdue might have been a touchdown if Haskins led his receiver more. Yes, his receiver was able to draw a defensive pass interference penalty, but this should have been a deep completion instead of a 15-yard gain due to penalty. Now, the thing with Haskins, and I feel like a broken record at this point, is that it's not that he misses every single deep throw or anything like that. He made some incredible jaw-dropping passes this season. They flashed everything you look for in a quarterback. But again, the issue simply comes down to consistency. As I was looking for other trends, and really the reason why I saw this inconsistency seemed to revolve all around his footwork. This is something he needs to work on. Additionally, any movement type of throw leaves a lot to be desired. He's definitely better going from his left to his right than he is at moving right to his left, but he's still a bit spotty if he's forced to leave the pocket. This is usually at odds with your typical college quarterback. Haskins is by far the best pocket passer in this class. From purely a mechanical standpoint, Haskins doesn't follow through with his hips when he releases the ball. He'll strain his plant leg or his left foot, and then will deliver the ball mostly with his arm. He's pretty accurate with his motion, and he has the ability to complete passes from all platforms and angles, but his footwork hurts him when he has to make an instant throw after resetting his feet. He missed a lot on this motion. Now, I haven't talked a ton about arm strength or body composition in this video yet, but he's clearly got the franchise arm and body size that should make any team happy. He can make all the throws. Hash the sideline and deep 55-yarders on a rope seem to look effortless. His bullet pass from a crowded pocket is also very impressive. He does a good job shortening his throwing motion to get the ball quickly. In my opinion, once he fixes his footwork, this should lead to a more consistent delivery on all of his passes. Again, he's far from inaccurate, so don't misunderstand me, but like any prospect we look at on this channel, it's just something he has to work on. While we hit on the main things like accuracy, football IQ, and anticipation, I wanted to go back to Haskins as a pocket passer. I think he has a pretty good sense of the pocket. He usually does a good job moving around to set up for his throws, and he has a really good sense for the pocket instantly collapsing around him. He can go from read to react to avoid an instant sack, and I think with more experience, he's going to get better at using his feet to make throws outside the pocket. While you have the quarterbacks like the Patrick Mahomes and the Russell Wilsons of the world that are incredible at extending plays, Haskins isn't that type of quarterback. He needs to continue practicing under pressure to get more quickly through his reads, and he also needs to keep working on improvising outside the structure of his offense. In my opinion, he's a bit systematic as of right now, but he did show flashes of that big play potentially looked for. I think it will come with time, and if he gets drafted into a very structured offense like a West Coast passing game, I think he's going to keep getting better. Before we get to his pro comparison, I wanted to point out what another media member said about Haskins. Stephen A. Smith called Haskins more of a runner than a passer. Well, as you've seen by now, this is objectively wrong. With Haskins' 1.4 yards per carry average, and me literally writing down that Haskins can be a bit awkward while scrambling, please ignore everything Stephen A. Smith has to say. Moving on, when I look at Haskins and for his pro comparison, the player I see is another Big Ten quarterback. I see a lot of Kirk Cousins. Now, before you get angry and yell at me, please hear me out. What makes Cousins good is that he's a very systematic quarterback in his ability to get through his progressions. He stands confidently in the pocket, and he can quickly go through his reads. He has full field vision, and he's a perfect fit for a West Coast-style offense based on his quick throwing motion and accuracy. He's also very smart, but his issues are well documented as well. How he plays under pressure and his lack of big play potential due to his poor improvisational skills is why he's not a top 5 quarterback in the NFL. Now, while I do see some of those traits, I think Haskins has a much higher ceiling. I think he has the ability to create on his own, and he's already shown flashes of the high quality traits that does make Cousins good. If you want to say Kirk Cousins 2.0 for this comparison, I think that's a fair assessment. Time will obviously tell. Now, I'm going to leave you with one last thing to think about as I wrap up this video. I gave Haskins an early to mid first round grade based on the improvement I saw on tape. Even in this one season, Haskins got better as the year went on. He was better in terms of pocket awareness, and he was definitely better at playing off schedule. I think given the right opportunity, Haskins can become one of the better quarterbacks in the NFL. As I mentioned at the start of this video, this scouting report was generously sponsored by my friends at manscaped.com. If you're in the market for a new below the belt or general full body male grooming kit, I would look no further. This kit features a waterproof electric trimmer called the lawnmower that is specially designed to prevent nicks while in the area of your body that you frankly never want to accidentally nick. What's nice is that with its ceramic blade and strong polycarbonate frame, it's very reliable and can withstand all the basic drops. If you're like me, this happens way too frequently. Yes, I fully admit, I wouldn't make for a good running back in the NFL. In addition to this trimmer, this kit also includes an excellent safety razor called the Plow. If you're looking for a close shave on your face or other parts of your body, this thing is excellent to give you a nice clean cut. For me personally, I live in the real world equivalent of Winterfell, so I try to keep a full beard at all times. However, while I clearly don't look like Kit Harington, my beard is much more stylish than his, and that's all due to this double-sided stainless steel safety razor. This kit also includes a deodorant and refresher spray, which are both great for on-the-go usage. Now, I was a bit nervous about putting anything like this in my downstairs area, but their Crop Preserver deodorant and their Crop Reviver refresher spray both feel fantastic. If you know the phrase swamp ass and you want to make sure your entire lower half is ready for action, these are two great products included in this package. As a special discount to viewers in this channel, Manscaped is offering 20% off your order if you use the code SAM20. Using this code, you'll also receive a nice shed travel bag, which is good to take these items on the road, and you'll also receive free shipping. I highly recommend giving them a try, especially considering you get a 30-day money-back guarantee if you don't like it. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'll have more draft content coming out soon leading up through April, so you make sure you look out for that. Also, you can follow me on Twitter at Samuel R. Gold.